What do you think about when you think of politeness? If you are like a lot of people, you might think of manners and formal speech. But wait, instead, when you hear the word politeness, think of it as just using the most appropriate language for any given context. For example, less formal language would be more polite with a close friend. What is polite is defined both by the cultures in which people are communicating as well as the people having the conversation. Think about Mike, a speaker of English who lives in the Midwestern United States. If he invited somebody to a party and they said no, he probably wouldn't continue to insist that they come. Why? Because it might seem pushy. However, Carla, a speaker of Colombian Spanish, might feel that if she didn't insist, the invitee wouldn't know that the invitation was sincere. So by not insisting, she actually feels like she is running the risk of being offensive. In short, politeness is complicated. One way to think about politeness orientation within a language you are studying is to think about group and individual orientation. If a speaker in the language has a high group orientation, he or she would likely emphasize making and keeping plans, use more plural pronouns like we relative to singular pronouns like I, and emphasize sincerity through repetition. On the other hand, speakers who are more individually oriented tend to protect individuality and freedom of action. For example, these speakers might use questions like how are you as greetings instead of invitations to conversations, use invitations to future events as a way to end a conversation rather than to make an actual plan, and accept invitation refusals quite quickly. Given all of this variety, what's a language learner to do? Pay attention, observe, and recognize the politeness orientation of the people you are communicating with, and choose your words based on what you see and hear around you. If you can do that, you can manage any communication that arises.